Good morning. I hope you all are good at your home. So today we are going to study The Friendly Mongoose, chapter number 2 of the second book, Supplement Reader, that is in your course. And please take out your books, open your books and open the page number is not given here. You can find out, okay? So class, let me tell you a little about this chapter. In this chapter, you will be able to understand that we should not leap on the decision without knowing the facts. Because sometimes it happens that we generally judge people without knowing the facts, without knowing the reality, without knowing the behind scenes. So, whenever we are going to take the decision, we should ponder about it, about the decision. We should ponder about the situation, then only we will be able to take the correct decision for any circumstances. Okay? Class, Andy, put yourself. Okay. Now, as you can see in this story, the title is The Friendly Mongoose. Actually, in the story, you will see that there was a family of three people. There was a man, his wife, a farmer, his wife, and they were having a small child. And they were living in a village. They were also having a pet that was a mongoose. Do you know what is mongoose? Okay, there is a small kind of animal. So, mongoose was the pet of the farmer's family. They were thinking, they were planning that in the future, mongoose will be the best friend of their child. That's why they kept the animal, the small animal, so that because it is very playful and it will be the best companion for their child. So let's start the story. But later what happened? The story ends with the death of the mongoose. But how it happened, let's see. And the death of the mongoose left the lady with regret for forever. So what had happened, that it came to the death of the mongoose. So here is the story. Three characters are there. First a farmer, then his wife, and third one, that is a small child. And the main character of this story is mongoose, a baby mongoose. Okay? So next, once a farmer and his wife lived in a village with their small son. They loved him very much. We must have a pet. It means it is the statement, it has been told by the speaker, it means the family members, that we must have a pet. It means we should have a pet. And the farmer said to his wife one day. It means they have started planning to keep a pet. So they started looking forward to keep a pet, but first time they have to select that which kind of pet they should domesticate. So when our son grows up, he will need a companion because he was the only child. So they were thinking that if there would be a companion to him, so he must be busy and he will be busy with that person or with that pet, so that it will be helpful for them also, so that they can do all the things without any tension, without any concern about the baby. If that is that, either we will be increased. Okay. Then our son grows up, he will need a companion. This pet will be our son's companion. So they have decided that they will be a mongoose that will be in the future the companion of the child. So his wife liked the idea. So one evening the farmer brought with him a tiny mongoose. It's a baby mongoose, said his wife. But it will be fully grown and he will be the friend to our son. When they brought the mongoose, it was a baby. But they were knowing that in the later time it will become grown up, and that when the child will be grown, grown up, the Moomoos will also be grown up. So it will be the both the companion will be grown up and they will have a good chemistry with each other because they will be living with the same place so that they will be able to understand their own bondings.
Just like a family.
Okay. So one day the family brought with him So you can see in the picture also that the wife of the farmer and the farmer both are talking to each other and farmer brought mongoose for his wife and for the future for his child. Okay, now come on the next page. Both the baby on mongoose grew. It means they started growing with the same atmosphere. And in 5 or 6 months, the mongoose had grown to its full size. You know that the small animals, they generally grows very speedily. You know that whenever you will find in your home also, that any animal that is bigger, it will take a little more time than a smaller animal. So that you can see, if you will find a mouse at your home, it grows with a great pace, and in spite of the mouse, you will find an elephant. It will not grow a little within 2 years. The years, it means I'm talking about the 24 months it will take, but he will not grow a little bit. So it means all the animals having their different anatomy. That's why they are having different heights, different weight, and all the animals having different quality how to grow. So next one, that is in 5 or 6 months the mongoose had grown to its full size. It became young. Who became young? The mongoose became young. And a lovely animal with two shining black eyes. It was having very shining black eyes, just like mouse, and a bushy tail. So it means it was having a great fur on the tail of the mongoose. So the farmer's son was still a baby. But in the 5 and 6 months, the baby will not grow like young man. Okay? It takes many years to become a young man for a baby, for a human baby. So sleeping and crying alternatively. It means what was the baby doing? When he grown up, it means the mongoose grown up, the baby was only baby in the cradle. Cradle, it means there is a place where the baby has been kept to make him sleep at the bedtime or at the daytime also. So sleeping and crying alternatively. So what he was doing was sleeping and crying. It was the main schedule of the baby. So one day the farmer's wife wanted to go to the market. So one day it happened that she fed the baby. It means she put the food, she has given the food to the baby, her baby, I am not talking about the mongoose, and rocked him to sleep in his little cradle. It means he started waving and he started moving the baby in the cradle by keeping the baby in the cradle so that it may help the baby to sleep easily. Okay. Picking up the basket, she said to her husband, "I am off to bazaar. The baby is sleeping and keep an eye on him. Frankly, I don't like to leave the child alone with the mongoose." Who is saying? The woman was a little afraid. You can say that a little afraid. He was not actually scared about the presence of mongoose. But in her mind there was an insecurity about the child. You know that every mom having some kind of insecurity for their child. Like whenever you will see some mother dog, you will see that if she finds that someone is hurting, someone is teasing the puppies of the dog, she will go and bark on those strangers.
Why? Because she feels that insecurity. Sometimes it also happens that your pet will also bark on you. If you are going to hurt the puppy, if it is there any possibility, the mother of the dog finds that my master is also hurting my child, then also she could bark. So it means that there is a possibility of the insecurity of a mom for her child or for her children. So it is quite natural for a mom. So that's why the wife of the farmer was also feeling that kind of insecurity to keep the baby with mom. Okay, now that insecurity feeling comes with some very bad result. That unfortunate result, what happened? Let's see. One day the farmer's wife wanted to go. Sorry. Okay, now come on the next. You needn't be afraid. Who said? The farmer, the father of the baby said that you needn't be afraid. The mongoose is a friendly animal. Okay? And it's as sweet as our baby. And they are the best of the friends, you know. The wife went away and the father, having nothing to do in the house, so he decided to go out and take a look at his fields not far away. It means he was having many fields, but some of the fields were very near to the house. That's why he thought that he should go to look after the fields, that what is happening in the fields, if there is any problem in the field. So he just went to visit the field, and he ran into some friends on the way back and didn't return for quite some time. It means for a little time the baby was alone with mongoose, and nobody was there to see what happened during that time when the baby was alone with mongoose. The farmer's wife finished her shopping and came back home with a basket full of the groceries. She saw the mongoose sitting outside as if waiting for her, and on seeing her, he ran to welcome her as was customary. You know that whenever you will go to the home by attending your school, by attending your office, you will be find that your pet is waiting for you. It always happens. If you are having a dog, if you are having your cat, you will find that your pet must be waiting for you, because the animal are also having that feeling, that care, that bonding towards the other family members, especially to the younger ones. Okay, so the farmer's wife took one look at the mongoose and screamed, "Blood!" It means the mouth of the mongoose was filled with blood, and the face and the paws of the mongoose were smeared with blood. It was totally, it means applied on the mouth of the mongoose, and it was totally scary for the mother, because he was already very scared about the presence of the mongoose with the baby, and he was also insecure about it. That's why he took the decision that what happened. He just praised and she didn't pay any attention to go to see what happened. He just took a decision. What decision? For you wicked animal, you have killed my baby. She screamed hysterically. Hysterically means in some crazy way. Strictly means if somebody finds something bad happened to him, it becomes crazy, it becomes inhuman, some madness it comes to his mind, that is called hysterically. So here it is said that he was started crying hysterically with the madness, and she was blind with rage. Rage means anger. She became angry that the baby was killed by the mongoose, because he was having the blood on the mouth of the mongoose, and with all the her strength brought down the heavy basket full of the groceries on the blood smeared mongoose and ran inside to the child's cradle. It means first what he did, first he thrown the full of the basket that was full of the groceries on the head of the mongoose. And when it was totally covered with the groceries of the basket, then he went into the room where the baby was sleeping and where she left the baby. She found that the child was in the cradle and the baby was fast asleep. But on the floor lay a black snake, torn and bleeding. There was a snake, you can see in the picture also, that there was a snake, and just near that the snake there was a lot of blood. That means that mongoose killed the snake. That's why the blood was applied on the mouth and paws of the mongoose. You know that the snake and mongoose both are a great enemy to each other. They are born enemy, you know. So it has been considered that they are born enemy. So, but on the floor lay back a black snake, torn and bleeding. In a flash, it means for the past what happened. She realized that what had happened, and she ran out looking for the mongoose. It means suddenly she came to know about that what had happened, because she can understand that the baby was sleeping, nothing happened to him, and only there was a snake, it was bleeding, and she could understand that what had happened in the past in the absence of her. When she came to know, she realized her mistake, that she shouldn't have done, shouldn't have thrown the basket on the mongoose. So now she went outside to see what happened to the mongoose, and oh, you saved my child, you killed the snake, what have I done? Now she started weeping, because she has done very wrong with mongoose. Without knowing the fact, without knowing the situation, she just took the decision and just threw the basket on the mongoose, just to take the revenge for the killing of her child. And then, oh, you saved my child, you killed the snake, what have I done? She cried, touching the mongoose, who lay dead and still and unaware of her sobbing. Sobbing, you know, when you cry, your tears comes out of your eyes, then your breathing sometimes choked, that is calling the sobbing, that is the sound comes, that is calling the sobbing, okay? And the farmer's wife, who had acted hastily and rashly, stared long at the dead mongoose. Then she heard the baby crying. Wiping her tears, she went into to feed him. It means now the baby started crying, and she went into to feed the baby because the baby was crying for the food. Whenever some baby awake, it usually cries. Okay. So it means that in the story we came to know that we should not leap upon the decision without knowing the facts, because sometimes it happens that you are thinking something different, something beyond, that is not the complete and exact story. Okay, thank you, class.